morning. This is a special event and a special day for everybody who's here, not the least of whom is me. So I want to apologize first because I couldn't do a video. So I'm sorry, you have to get me in person. But one of the things that's the most fun for me in my life is introducing people to people. I don't know if you can have a Chinese term, you must, the Yiddish term for yenta. Yenta is someone who sets up marriages. So a lot of what I think I do in my life is like being a male yenta. Because there's always women who do this, but at least some men can do it now and then. And the one thing that's a little bit probably not so healthy or not so smart is I then forget. I kind of remember bringing you guys here, but I don't think about it a lot. So like it happens and then just let it go. And it's amazing to just watch what's unfolding. Of course, this place right here is a very special place to me. I first started visiting Master Nan when he still lived in Hong Kong, and we would all get together. My first visit was in 1996, so it was a long time ago. So I think many of you have met, but if not, maybe you do today meet the Lee family who have really held the space and the process that eventually has resulted in this wonderful facility. So David and Sammy and Shumai become like a part of my own extended family. Two families weaving together. So of course there have to be lots of children running around. It's very important. So let me just close with a few ideas. I think I probably met Team Academy even before I met Master Nan. It's about the same time, but sometime in the mid-1990s, I visit Yavaskala, very different in Taihu. Another mentor of mine, a man named Ari de Huss, who had spent his career at Shell, said, "You got to come with me to Finland to visit this crazy school." And I learned about how young people learn how to create enterprises by creating enterprises. And I remember vividly sitting around and talking with them one afternoon and saying, "Well, you know, most young people around the world who want to learn about business or management, they go to a management school. What would it be like if you'd gone to a management school?" And they just shook their heads and they said, "How could you possibly learn about management by listening to somebody give lectures? How could you learn how to work with people by listening to lectures about human resources? How could you learn about the creative process, people creating something of real value together, by listening to some professor talk about it?" I mean, they were like, they thought this was really weird idea. So this idea, this really simple idea, that to learn you must do. To learn to be a manager, you must manage. To learn how to create an enterprise, you must create an enterprise. To learn how to work with people, you have to work with people. The only real way to learn is to do, together. I think I made my first visit to the Basque region around the same time. I get it all mixed up in my head. But somewhere around the same time, like 20 years ago, I made my first trip to Bilbao. I didn't actually get to San Sebastian at that time. And then I saw this wonderful kind of cultural heritage. Those of you who don't know the Basque region, is probably the most powerful example of what people can do together. It has a marvelous history of cooperatives. I remember when I was a college student, I first studied this cooperative called Mondragon. I thought, wow, what an amazing place this must be. Little did we know that eventually it would be Mondragon Team Academy. Because for several years, one of the questions many of us had is, this Team Academy model is an amazing model, but it has to take root someplace. There has to be a place where the soil is right for this type of seed. And the Basque region was the right type of soil because of this extraordinary history of people working together to accomplish things that they could have never accomplished if they didn't work together. So then there is, of course, the ideas, the principles, the understanding present here. So the last stage in the journey from Finland to San Sebastian, with a lot of stops along the way that didn't work too well, from Finland to San Sebastian to China and Taihu. So in addition to what Marie was saying about the importance of China, which of course many of us have felt for a long time, in the global changes occurring in the world, the fact that this country, it will be very important in shaping the 21st century. This last stop in the journey from Yavaskala to San Sebastian to Taihu, to me, kind of completes the circle. Because it is about creating, and it is about creating together. But the ultimate question is, for what purpose? The human is a very young species. If you look at all the other creatures who we share the planet with, most of them are very, very much older than we are. And one of the things we know from ecology or biology is that a species and a niche have to coexist. A species does not exist away from a niche, and a niche exists as a place or a home for a species. In my personal opinion, this particular species does not yet have a niche. Because on the one hand, there are many examples over the last 10,000 years of societies that last for thousands of years. There aren't too many, but there are many. China being one, many of the native peoples being another, but they always exist over a long period of time in a specific area. Their niche is local. But this particular species at this particular time seems to have this crazy idea that our niche could be the world as a whole. So that's a big question. What is our niche? What would it take in us as humans to operate in a healthy, balanced, long-term way in the planet as a whole? Because the one thing we can say for sure right now, today, is we don't know how to do this. We need a new story, a new mythos. It can't just be the mythos of the Chinese, or the Europeans, or the Americans. It has to be one that actually connects us, all of us. When we see the children running around, we really don't care if they're Chinese children, or Finnish children, or Spanish children, do we? We're just our children. This is the new mythos we will need on the earth. And I think vehicles like Team Academy from Yavaskala to San Sebastian to Taihu could be a key vehicle for making this new myth a reality. Because this is what he was trying to teach all of us. The time is over to be Chinese or Americans or Finns or Basques. It's a confusion of where we live with who we are. So we have to now rediscover who we are. Congratulations to the graduates of Team Academy. This is a very historic moment. And I'm really glad I couldn't join you by video. 谢谢.
Smile so sad.